हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वी कंटिन्यू अवर टॉपिक दैट इज़ एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द केमिकल क्लासेस ऑफ हॉर्मोन एंड द हाइपोथैलेमस एंड पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड. फर्स्ट द ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ क्लासेस केमिकल क्लासेस दीज हॉर्मोन आर डिवाइडेड इंटू टू क्लासेस. वन इज़ द लिपिड सॉल्युबल हॉर्मोन दैट कंटेन्स स्टेरॉइड हॉर्मोन, थायराइड हॉर्मोन एंड नाइट्रिक ऑक्साइड. द स्टेरॉइड हॉर्मोन इज डेरिवेटिव ऑफ कैलोस्ट्रोल एंड थायराइड हॉर्मोन इज सिंथेसाइज बाई अटैचिंग आयोडीन टू द अमाइनो एसिड ट्रायोसिन. ओके, एंड नाइट्रिक ऑक्साइड इज अ गैस हॉर्मोन विच इज विच एक्ट एज बोथ हॉर्मोन एंड न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर एंड इट इज synthesized by enzyme that is nitric oxide synthetase. Next is the water soluble hormone that contain amino acid peptide hormone and eicosanoid hormone. So the peptide hormone is synthesized by amine hormone is synthesized by the decarboxylation and it is the modification of certain amino acid. And peptide hormone, it is a protein hormone, polymer of amino acid, and these polymers, these amino acid in the polymer are attached by the peptide bond, and a common example is the insulin. Okay, eicosanoid hormone, these hormones are derived from the arachidonic acid. The arachidonic acid is a 20 carbon fatty acid. So this hormone is named as eicosanoid hormone. Eicos means have 20 carbon atom. Here we see the summary of a chemical hormone. First you see steroid hormone which have aldosterone, cortisol and androgen. Here this is derived from the adrenal cortex. Next is the calcitriol that is activate form of vitamin D. It is secreted by kidney. Next is the testosterone. This is secreted by testis, and androgen and progesterone, it is secreted by ovary. Thyroid hormone, here you see that is iodine is attached with the amino acid tyrosine. Okay, so these are the hormone T3 and T4. This is secreted by thyroid gland. The cell that is secreting this hormone is the follicular cell. Okay, next is the gas hormone, that is the nitric acid. This is a site of secretion of this hormone is the endothelium cell lining of the blood vessels. Okay. So the main function of this hormone is that they are help in the vasodilation. By secreting this hormone, they dilate the blood vessel and lowering the blood pressure. They also help in the erection of penis in the male. Next is the water soluble hormones. First is the amines. These are include epinephrine and non-epinephrine. Collectively called these hormone is catechol amines. And these hormones are secreted by the adrenal cortex. Adrenal medulla. So adrenal medulla secrete the water soluble hormone that is the epinephrine and non-epinephrine, and adrenal cortex secrete the lipid soluble hormones that are the aldosterone, cortisol and androgen. Okay. Next you see the peptide. So here you see epinephrine and norepinephrine, and these are secreted by adrenal medulla. Next is the peptide and protein hormone. So all hypothalamic releasing and inhibiting hormone are oxytocin, antidiuretic hormone, growth hormones, thyroid stimulating hormone, adrenocorticotropic hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, prolactin hormone, melanostimulating hormone. These are the protein hormone that are secreted. Their site of secretion is the hypothalamus, posterior pituitary gland and anterior pituitary gland. Okay, so these are the peptide hormones, and some are the hormones that are secreted by the pancreas are the insulin, glucagon, somatostatin, pancreatic polypeptide, these hormones are also the peptide hormone. Next is the parathyroid hormone that is secreted by the parathyroid gland. Next peptide hormone is the calcitonin that is secreted by the thyroid gland, that is the cell that secrete is the parafollicular cells. Okay, and next that is secreted by the stomach and the small intestine. These are the gastrin and stearin, cholecystokinin and glucose depending insulotropin peptide, and erythropoietin are also secreted by kidney. Leptin is adipose tissue that secretes the leptin. And the next you see eicosanoid are example of hormone are the prostaglandin and the leukotrienes, and these are secreted by the all cell excepted the red blood cell. Okay, so these hormones, the prostaglandin and the leukotrienes are secreted by all kind of the cell excepted the red blood cell. Next is the hormone transport in the blood. Most of the water soluble hormones are circulated in the watery blood plasma as a free, means the water soluble hormones are not be bound with the any compound to move from one cell, from secreting cell to the target cell. Okay, and in the lipid soluble hormone, they are bound with the transport protein, and these protein help to transport the lipid soluble hormone from secreting cell to the target cell, and these transport protein are synthesized in the liver. So here we see the function of transport protein. First is they make the lipid soluble hormone temporarily water soluble hormone. So these hormone are, so these protein are increase the solubility in the blood by the lipid soluble hormone are soluble in the blood. They retard passes of small hormone through the filtrating mechanism in the kidney. So in the nephron, the protein is not be secreted into the kidney. So these protein help to reabsorption of lipid soluble hormone. they provide ready reserve of hormone and already present in the bloodstream. So they act as a reservoir. So these protein are present in the blood, the lipid molecule are attached in the protein, these protein, and these protein act as a ready reserves. In general, 0.1 to 10% of the molecule of lipid soluble hormone are not bound with to the transport protein. Okay, so this only 0.1 to 10% of the molecule are not be bound with the transport protein. Here you see some action of lipid soluble hormone and water soluble hormone. First, here you see that in the blood capillary, the free hormone and the transport protein, they are bind together, and in the blood capillary, the free hormone are released in toward the target cell. So this is the lipid soluble hormone that is diffused into the cell and go inside the nucleus. Okay, in the nucleus this free hormone that activated receptor and hormone complex are formed. So this is the receptor that is where these free hormone are attached. Okay, this is the orange is the receptor where the free hormone are get attached and make a receptor activator receptor hormone complex. After that, they form a DNA pattern, and DNA is converted into mRNA, and mRNA come out of the out of the nucleus, and it form a new protein molecule through the transcription. Okay, the new protein alter the cell activity. So as you know, the how the chemical change is occur in the body, it is all through by the protein formation by that hormone and that enzyme. Okay, when the new protein is formed, our body react about that new protein. Okay, so first the hormone enter into the nucleus and attach with the receptor and form a DNA. DNA converted into RNA through the transcription, and the mRNA attached with the ribosomes from translation of occur and make a new protein. And in the water soluble hormone, that is the free hormone that binding of the hormone to the receptor, that is the G protein. Okay, so here that is a water soluble is combined with the receptor, and here one G protein is attached, and one adenylate acetate. So by that, one ATP is changed into the CMP. This CMP is the second messenger hormone. Okay, so that CMP is used to convert the protein kinase into activated protein kinase. Okay, CMP serves as a second messenger to activate the protein kinase. Okay, that activated protein kinase is a kinase phosphorylate the cellular protein. Okay, so here the protein, the cell that is change into protein plus one phosphate attached with that protein. Okay, so this is known as phosphorylate cellular protein. So this activator protein kinase change the protein into phosphorylate protein. Okay, so by that the change in the protein occur and that hormone act on that target cell. Okay, got this point? Now we see the control on hormone secretion. Hormone secretion is regulated by three way. First is the signal from the nervous system. Next is the chemical change in the blood. And another one is the hormones. In first, chemicals from the nervous system. For example, the nerve impulse of the adrenal medulla regulate the release of epinephrine. Okay, so release of epinephrine is regulated by the nerve impulse. Okay, and in the change in the chemical in the blood is through, for example, when the blood calcium level is decrease, the parathyroid hormone secretion will increase. Through this, the any change in the blood, the secretion of hormone occur. Okay, and other one is the hormone. For example, an hormone from the anterior pituitary stimulate the release of cortisol by the adrenal cortex. Okay, so signal go into the anterior pituitary gland to secrete the to stimulate the secretion of cortisol through the adrenal cortex. Okay, so through any change in the hormone, the another hormone stimulate the secretion of this hormone. Okay, so you clear this term. First is the signal from the nervous system, any change in the chemical in the blood, another is the hormone. You see the hypothalamus and pituitary gland is the master gland of the endocrine system. Pituitary itself has a master, that is the hypothalamus. Pituitary gland is a P-shaped structure whose dimension are 1 to 1.5 cm. It attaches to the hypothalamus through the infundibulum, and pituitary gland have two functional and anatomical separate portion. First is the anterior pituitary gland, we also know as adenohypophysis. Another is the posterior pituitary gland, this is also known as neurohypophysis. Anterior pituitary gland have two part in the adult. One is the paradistal and another is the pars tubularis. Posterior pituitary gland also consists of two part. One is the pars nervosa and another is the pars intermedia. So pars nervosa is the tubule. Now we see the anterior pituitary cell and the hormones. Somatotrophin. These cells are present. So somatotropin is the cell that is present in the anterior pituitary gland, and that secretes the growth hormone, and also known as human growth hormone. And this is also known as somatotrophin. Okay, next cell is the thyrotrophus, secrete the thyrostimulating hormone and also known as thyrotropin. Next, the gonadotrophus that secrete the follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. That next cell is the lactotrophus that secrete the prolactin. नेक्स्ट इज द कॉर्टिकोट्रोफस सेल दैट्स क्रिएट द एड्रिनोकॉर्टिकोट्रॉफिक हार्मोन एंड सम ऑफ द कॉर्टिकोट्रोफस रिमेंट इन द पार्स इंटरमीडिया दैट आल्सो सिक्रीट द मेलानोसाइट स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन. ओके नाउ हाइपोथैलेमस एंड पिट्यूटरी anterior pituitary control. Okay, how the hypothalamus control on the anterior pituitary gland. Okay, so here growth hormone releasing hormone that stimulate the secretion of growth hormone. Okay, in the hypothalamus have a hormone that is growth hormone stimulating hormone that stimulate on the growth hormone. Next is the thyrotropin releasing hormone that stimulate on the secretion of thyroid stimulating hormone. Next is corticotrophic stimulating hormone that stimulate on the adrenocortic hormone. Next is the prolactin stimulating hormone that stimulate the secretion of prolactin. And next is the gonadotropin releasing hormone that stimulate on the FSH and LH. And in the hypothalamus have two inhibiting hormone that suppress the secretion of anterior pituitary gland hormone. These are the growth hormone inhibiting hormone that suppress the activity of the growth hormone, and the next is prolactin hormone inhibiting hormone that suppress the prolactin secretion. Here we see the hypophyseal portal system. So hypothalamic hormone that release and inhibit the anterior pituitary hormone are transported by the portal system. So in the portal system, the blood flow from one capillary network into the portal vein and then into the second capillary network before entering the heart. So in the portal system, first blood is flow from one capillary network into the portal vein and then go into the second capillary network before entering the heart. Blood flow from capillary in the hypothalamus into the portal vein that carry the blood into the capillary of the anterior pituitary. Okay, the superior hypophyseal artery is the branch of the anterior corticoid artery bring the blood into the hypothalamus. So superior hypophyseal arteries I will show you with the diagram. So first we study the theory, then we go into the diagram. So the superior hypophyseal artery is the branch of the internal carotid artery. So in our body there are many types of artery, like temporal artery, brachial artery, radial artery. So there is carotid artery that is present in the neck. So the branch of the carotid artery, that is the internal carotid artery, that bring the blood into the hypothalamus. So this artery is known as a superior hypophyseal artery. Okay, at the junction between the middle eminence and the infundibulum, these artery are divided into capillaries. Okay, so these artery are at that point, at this junction, are divided into the capillary network. So this capillary network is known as the primary plexus. Plexus is the network, means this is the network of the capillary. Okay, so this system is known as primary plexus of hypophyseal portal system. Okay, and this primary plexus is go into the anterior pituitary gland through the hypophyseal portal vein. So the hypophyseal portal vein drain the blood into the pituitary outside the infundibulum. The network of hypophyseal portal vein get divided into the capillary into the anterior pituitary gland is known as the secondary plexus of hypophyseal portal system. So second plexus is formed by the hypophyseal portal vein. So that hypophyseal portal vein is divided into a network of capillary and form a secondary plexus, and primary plexus is formed by the network of superior hypophyseal artery. Okay, and that secondary plexus of hypophyseal are change into the hypophyseal vein that drain the blood from the anterior pituitary gland. So first you see by the diagram here, you see hypophyseal portal system. First, this is the superior hypophyseal artery. Okay, that arrow is go, that is the red colored artery go into the infundibulum is the superior hypophyseal artery. Okay, and that make a primary capillary plexus. Okay, here you see the network, that is the network of artery. So it make a primary capillary plexus. Okay, and here you see third is the hypophyseal portal vein. So this is the blue colored vein are the hypophyseal portal vein. Okay, next is the secondary capillary plexus. These are the secondary capillary plexus that is formed by the hypophyseal portal vein. This is the plexus, secondary plexus, and that plexus is changed into the hypophyseal vein that drain the blood from the anterior pituitary gland. Okay, you clear with this? So this is the superior hypophyseal, that vein arteries go into the infundibulum and make a network. Okay, the network of capillary. This network is known as the primary plexus of hypophyseal portal system, and that is go out into the anterior pituitary through the veins, and these veins are known as hypophyseal portal veins. These portal veins are divided into the capillary network. This is the capillary network, this is blue colored, this is the capillary network, and this capillary network is known as the secondary capillary plexus. And these capillary plexus are join and make a hypophyseal vein that drain the blood out the anterior pituitary. Okay, in this picture you clear that this is the hypothalamus. Okay, this is the above one is the hypothalamus, and that is attached with the pituitary gland. These two are the pituitary, one is the anterior pituitary gland and another one is the posterior pituitary gland. Okay, so these the hypothalamus is and pituitary gland are attached through the infundibulum. So this is an stalk like appearance is known as the infundibulum. Okay, in this diagram we are going to see the hypothalamus and the pituitary gland part. Okay, so here you see the pituitary gland,
this is the pituitary gland and attached by the pendulum to the hypothalamus. So this is the stalk like structure. This is the pendulum, and the pituitary gland is covered by the bone, that is the siphonoid bone. This is the space that is hypophyseal fossa in the cella turcica of the siphoid bone. And so this is the anterior pituitary gland. Have three part. One is the pars tubularis, that is the light brown color that surround the posterior pituitary gland and the infundibulum. Okay, and this is the pars intermedia, that is present between two anterior and posterior gland, and this is a large part. This is the large part is known as the pars distalis. Okay, and now we see the posterior pituitary. This is the infundibulum stalk, and this is the large part is the of the anterior pituitary gland is the pars nervosa. Okay, I hope you clear with this diagram. That is the our brain. This is the hypothalamus. Large part is the thalamus, and the small the hypothalamus, and the that is attachment of the pituitary gland. Okay, this is the median amenasis and the infundibulum. Here the in this junction the primary plexus of hypothalamus portal system is formed. In this junction there we found the first primary plexus, and in the anterior pituitary part you see the second plexus, and in this outside the infundibulum you see the hypothalamic hypophyseal portal vein. Okay, thank you. Now I hope you understand the video.